Good morning children, class 6. We have today the rest of our grammar portions. So last classes we were learning about the kinds of sentences, and today we have the last kinds of sentence, that is the exclamatory sentence. So here we have a definition about the exclamatory sentence, that a sentence that express our feelings or emotions are called exclamatory sentence. In a sentence which we have seen our emotions or feelings, if it will be sadness or happy or enjoying or surprise, it's everything just included at the exclamatory sentence, and they end with an exclamation mark. Wherever we write and wherever we see an exclamatory sentence, it just starts with the exclamatory words. Somewhat, what, how. This is an exclamatory words, and always it ends with the exclamation mark. So here we have the definition about the exclamatory sentence, or sentence a sentence that express a sentence that express strong feelings or emotions are called exclamatory sentence. And they end with an exclamation mark. They end with an exclamation mark. What is that? This is the exclamation mark. For example, what a beautiful paint it is. What a beautiful painting it is. See, whenever we write or we say about an exclamatory sentence, always we should remember the three importance, that an exclamatory sentence express only our feelings and emotions. And next one, an exclamatory sentence ends with an exclamation mark. And the third one, it usually begins with the exclamation words, that is what and how. Okay, what and how. So here's an activity for you that you have to do in your notebook. Okay, so value based activity it is, that an exclamatory sentence express our feeling, that all of us know. So here a question for you. Your friend or your classmate have participated in a dance competition. Okay, just think that your classmate and your friend has participated in a dance competition. Your friend dances better than you. Okay, your friend dances better than you. So will you appreciate him or her? Will you appreciate him or her? Why? Why not? If you appreciate, why? If you are not appreciate her, why not? This answer you have to write in your notebook. Will you do it? Okay. So here an example for you, and you have to do this activity in your notebook. Thus, in a page number, I think already have purchased your textbook and all. Now, and if it's not have purchased till now, please get it from the school. Okay. So Take page number 6 and there is a exercise A. Rewrite the sentences given below as exclamatory sentence using how or what. Some sentences are given there for you. Okay, I think it's 5 or 5, only 5 sentences are given there. You have to make it this as a exclamatory sentence using what or how. Will you do it? Okay. So the next we have, so here we already have finished our kinds of sentences and we already have got the homeworks and all. Please do it in your notebook regularly. And next we have the kinds of, not kinds of, parts of sentence. Okay, that already you know that what is the parts of sentence. It is subject and predicate. Okay, in a sentence we have two parts. If we divide a sentence, we have two parts. It's called a subject and a predicate. So here an example for you. The people in the ground were enjoying the match. The people in the ground were enjoying the match. So from this sentence we have to find out the subject and predicate. So can anyone guess what is the subject? So I think some of you will say that the people. I think some of you will be say that the people. So the people, that is a subject. But whenever we say a subject in a sentence, it's a part of a sentence that tells us who or what the sentence is about. Here who means the people and what the sentence means they were in the ground. Okay, the people in the ground, people was in the, the people were in the ground. So a subject is a part of a sentence that tells us who and what in a sentence is about. So then what is the predicate now? So these are the predicate that they are enjoying the match. Why? Because a predicate is a word or a group of words that tells us about the subject. A predicate is a word or group of words that tells us about the subject. What subject is doing, that the predicate says. Okay, subject kya karti hai, wo predicate humko bol sakta hai. Theek hai? So a subject is a sentence, that always we know that the subject is a sentence that tells us who or what in the sentence about, what talking about. But the predicate means a word or group of words that tells about the subject. Again one more example I will give. All the students are ready for the picnic. All the students are ready for the picnic. Can you find out from here the subject and predicate? Good. The subject is all the students and predicate is are ready for the picnic. Understood now? Again one more example. My father loves orange juice. Here the subject, all of us know that my father. My father. Predicate is loves orange juice. Okay. So here we wind up our class for this much. After we have the next class for tomorrow.